NASL Championship Soccer is brought to you by Toyota. You asked for soccer and you got it. Thanks to Toyota, makers of quality cars and trucks. Toyota, the official car of the NASL. And by the Miller Brewing Company, brewers of Miller High Life. If you've got the time, we've got the beer. And by the people in your town who also bring you the bright, refreshing taste of Coca-Cola. Coke adds life to just about everything you do.
Boy, what I'd give for one of those Toyotas that's got room for us and all this stuff.
You asked for it. The Toyota Corolla Liftback. Go ahead, load her up. It's built with plenty of room for people and things. Then take it just about anywhere because Toyotas can take it. They're built tough and they're built dependable. In fact, if you can find a better built small car than Toyota, buy it.
You asked for it, you got it, Toyota.
Chef Messing for smokeless tobacco.
I love soccer. And I love tobacco. But I don't light up. I get my tobacco pleasure the smokeless way. So can you. With mild Happy Days Mint, Skoll with the fresh wintergreen flavor, and Copenhagen for straight tobacco taste. Just a little pinch between your cheek and gum is all it takes. The best part of going smokeless? It's really relaxing. Try so.
Hello, everyone, from Hollander Stadium in Rochester, New York. John Miller for TVS, and today we've got a dandy. We've got the Cosmos, and we have the upstart Rochester Lancers. For the Atlantic Conference Championship, one of these two ball clubs, 1 week from today, will be in Soccer Bowl 77. Quite a study in contrasts. The high-powered, high-priced Cosmos, and a ball club of very tight-fisted, rough-housing ball club, the Rochester Lancers. They had four men ejected in two ball games with Toronto this past week. So we've got, again, the study in contrast. We've got the big guns from the Big Apple and the upstarts from upstate. We'll be back in just a moment to meet our special guest commentator for the ball game today, and we continue in a moment. Our special guest commentator this week is Paul Gardner, the noted soccer author, the journalist, the man who's been following soccer since its infancy here in the United States. Now here's Paul with a look at the two ball clubs today.
Thank you, John. Turning first to the Rochester Lancers, now on defense. Jim Pollahan, an American, and of course he's from St. Louis. We always seem to end up talking about St. Louis players when we're talking about Americans. He came to this club, he was a center forward, a goal scorer. They didn't need a center forward, they needed a left fullback. They picked Jim Pollahan, and he's done marvelously well there. Left-footed player, he's done so well that, in fact, they've made him the captain of the team. Playing alongside him in the fullback line, Miralem Faslich, who's been voted the player of the year by the media in Rochester here. Very, very good positional player and superbly cool. So cool, in fact, he'll dribble out of situations that really worry the coach. Turning to the attack of Rochester, Mike Stojanovic. Now, here is a very, very fast player indeed. Over 20 yards, probably as fast as anybody in the league. Give him the ball, let him run onto it, he'll score goals. Tremendous right foot shot. In fact, he scored 14 goals and 5 assists for this team. And he responded with some marvelous attacking play. We saw him in the semi-final against Fort Lauderdale score a marvelous goal, lay on a goal for Canalia. Absolutely wonderful dribbling. Pelé playing better now, I think, than he's played all season, and this undoubtedly is a response to huge crowds of the Cosmos have been getting at Giants Stadium, and of course, playoff games. When the chips are down, Pelé plays, and he plays beautifully. Also playing, I think, better than he has all season, Quinalia, responding, I think, to a change in coaching. The arrival of Eddie Firmani seems to have led to a reborn Quinalia. He, again, 5 goals, 2 assists in the playoff, just 3 games, and that is another playoff record. John?
All right, Paul, thank you. And we'll be back with the opening kickoff of this Atlantic Conference Championship game in just a moment. Right, right. Got it. Well, this is well timed. This is Hollander Stadium in Rochester, New York. The largest crowd here ever before was 17-6. Today, about 20. There's Eddie Firmani, the coach of the Cosmos, has coached them to 6 wins in their last 7 games, including 3 consecutive wins in the playoffs. And Dragan Popovich, the coach of the Rochester Lancers, who's brought them to the playoffs for the 2nd consecutive year. They, too, have won 3 consecutive games in the playoffs. The referee for the ball game in the middle, Jim Hyatt. The linesman, Mike Wirtz, on the left, and Don Byron on the right. And we're just about ready for kickoff from Hollander Stadium in Rochester. And the Cosmos have it first. They're in the green. These are the dark jerseys with the white trunks, moving from left to right. That is west to east here at Hollander Stadium in Rochester. We're underway. Terry Garvin with the ball for the Cosmos. Takes it back to Werner Ross, center back number 4, and the captain of the ball club. And now to Pelé, the Black Pearl, number 10. He'll be in the front line today. Pelé leads the ball to midfield. It's knocked down and taken away by Escos, number 16. Rochester has it. Cisco Escos, midfielder, to Pollahan, number 12, left fullback and the captain. And now our first foul of the ball game against Tony Field, number 7. Escos was knocked over. Rochester has played some very rough games in the playoffs. They've had 4 men ejected in their last 2 playoff games, and they've received 7 yellow caution cards. So, Paul, that's kind of a staggering figure there.
It's a lot. I wouldn't want to base what's going to happen in this game on that, though. I mean, they treat this game exactly as it is. We're going to see a lot of close marking in this game, that's for sure.
This is Pedro into the right wing corner. Crossing ball in front is headed by Garbett and just pops over the crossbar. Rochester coming out on the attack. They had Ibrahim Silva, number 11, in front with Bakic and Stojanovic.
That wasn't a good move by Garbett. He didn't head that well at all. He hurt his head on it, and in fact, it came down sort of within range of the goal. A very poor header by Garbett.
Number 10, John Pedro, veteran. 1 goal, 8 assists this year. Playing in midfield to take the corner kick. In front, they've got Bakic, number 9. Mijatovic, the strong defender, moves up on this corner. Here comes a header attempt by Dregi, number 2, also a fullback, moving up on the attack, but it pops over the end line, and a Cosmos goal kick, last touch by the Lancers.
Contesting that header was the story of the afternoon, I suppose, as far as the Cosmos is concerned. Paul Hunter playing a fullback, a youngster only out of college last year, taking a starting place from Smith, who's injured. This will be a real test for Hunter.
He was the 2nd draft choice of the Cosmos, although chosen in the 1st round. They had 2 first-round picks. Now this is Franz Beckenbauer. Leaves it for Pelé. They call it offside. I think Stevie Hudge in front was offside, not Pelé. Kind of a close call there. Linesmen don't make the call. They'll raise their flag and alert the referee that they've spotted it. And the referee, if he feels that it is a wrong call, it is obliged to make his own call to the play. Otherwise, he'll take their advice. Bakic has it knocked away. Rochester's Costa, Jose Costa, who's on a wing today, leaves it for Callahan, moving in an overlap on the left wing. And the veteran Carlos Alberto, the sweeper back of the Cosmos, is there, picking up the loose ends. Throw in Rochester. Callahan gets it in, intended for number nine. Bakic intercepted by the Cosmos, but given back to Escos. Pancho, they call him here. Now to Costa. Costa has been ejected from two games in the playoffs out of the three. Quinalia, Rochester, deadly at home. 11-3 at home this year. 21-5 at home the last 2 years. And the Cosmos have only won in Rochester once ever. In nine ball games in Rochester, one a victory for the Cosmos. Here's a quick chip. Beckenbauer in. Lee tries to drop it back. Now the Cosmos claim a handball in there. Referee says play on.
I don't think it was a handball, John. And if it was certainly unintentional. And, of course, you're not supposed to make the calls if the foul is unintentional in soccer.
Stevie Hunt was trailing the play. Beckenbauer, I think, tried to drop it back to him that time. And then when it was deflected by the defender, Hunt began waving his arm in the air. And that was what that was all about, hoping to get a call. Here comes Rochester, pass for Stojanovic, number seven, and watch for him today. Paul Gardner said at the outset, number seven, Mike Stojanovic. They call him the gunner here, and for good reason. He scored 31 goals the last 2 years.
We're certainly going to see him very tightly marked by Werner Roth. These two duels, I think, Mijatovic on Kinalia and Roth on Stojanovic, could well decide this game.
Beckenbauer knocks the ball loose. Pelé comes out with it. Took it away from Ibrahim Silva, second-year man for the Lancers. Now Pelé is blindsided by Pedro. Nice tackle. And then Silva just trips and falls in the turf. Correct that, Bakic, not Silva. It was Bakic, number nine. Here comes Tony Field. Leads a quick pass for Quinalia. He's onside. Mijatovic, number five, is on him. Quinalia takes it to the end line and gets the corner kick. Last touch by the Lancers. Quinalia has had five goals in three playoff games to lead all playoff scorers. This is Quinalia in the penalty area. Looks for an opening. Takes the shot. It's deflected by Escos and taken by number 11, Silva. Lancers get it out. Here comes Escos, midfielder on the left wing. And Werner Ross saw it coming. Deflects the ball, but Callahan, the Lancer captain. Now to Silva. Silva has scored the only goal the Lancers have scored in the playoffs. Their story in the playoffs has been a little bit of offense and a lot of defense. Just the opposite with the Cosmos. They scored 14 goals in the playoffs and have allowed five.
They have a crunching tackle just there by Garbutt on Silver. And in fact, it's left Silver on the ground. Garbutt was rubbing his leg. Silver still hasn't got up.
This is Stojanovic, the gunner, but they call the foul. Fans boo the call.
I'm still watching Silver in midfield. He's still in some pain out there.
From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer. Yeah.
Well, we got somebody else hurt now.
Pedro.
Yeah.
John Miller, Paul Gardner back at Hollander Stadium in Rochester, New York. for the championship of the Atlantic Conference. One of these teams will be seen 1 week from today in Soccer Bowl 77. Tonight at the Coliseum in Los Angeles, the Seattle Sounders, the champions of the West, meet the Los Angeles Aztecs, the champions of the South. That should be quite a game. They'll resume in Seattle on Thursday. Silva's attempted crossing pass knocked down by Alberto. Rochester throw in the extreme left wing corner. Silva's all right.
Silva's all right. Pedro, we had injured too. He got up and he's all right. So they've recovered completely, the Lancers.
Number 12, Follahan to throw it in. Deep in the corner. Goes for Stojanovic.
There's that duel, Ross on Stojanovic again.
Now Follahan has it on the left wing. Feeds it back near the 35 to Escos. Pele picks him up. Now to Costa. Pele picks him up. And now Hunter knocks it loose to Pele. But Costa comes right back to get it back for the Lancers. Got a really vocal crowd here today. They called a foul on Custer that time. Jim Hyatt, the referee. Paul, early on here, do you think the Cosmos have come out expecting a rough game?
No, I think the Cosmos have come out to attack, because I think it's been established that when you're playing away in these two-game series, the thing to do is to go for the win and not for the tie.
Well, there's the foul right there. He tripped the man going for the ball. Looks like he got the man first. Back to live action. Tony Field moving to the penalty area. He's got an opening. Look out. Drives and a shot. And he misses wide left.
I don't think Tony Field will forgive himself for that one. He beat his man beautifully. He had the shot. I didn't think Brand was in too good an angle on that, but Field certainly put that well wide.
Get another look at it here.
We feel from behind. Well, the shot goes well wide of the left upright.
Goal kick for the Lancers. No score in the match. We played 8 minutes of the first half here, as the city of Rochester, they're talking about soccer. The newspapers, on the streets, on television and radio, the talk was soccer. This is the perhaps one of the biggest sporting events ever to be held here in Rochester, New York. Cosmos have it. Carlos Alberto, captain of the world champions in Brazil in 70, or from Brazil. Beckenbauer was the captain of the world champions for West Germany, 1974.
That's right, John. We've got two captains who've held up the World Cup as winners. I don't think that's ever happened before in the history of soccer on one team.
On their roster, the Cosmos have 9 players who have had World Cup experience. This is Alberto. Lone chip. Pele will race for it, but Brand, 18 yards from the goal, and that is the limit that he can come out and grabbed the ball with his hands.
That's right. If he slid any further with that ball, it would have been a free kick for the Cosmos, handling outside the area.
The goalkeepers, that's why they're dressed differently, to distinguish them easily. And in that penalty area, 18 yards out from the goal and 18 yards either side of the goal, that's their area where they can touch the ball with their hands. Cosmos have it at midfield. Terry Garbutt scored the game winner in Fort Lauderdale in a shootout the other night, beating Gordon Banks. Now Kinalia. Now you have 15 goals in the regular season, the league's fourth leading scorer and the leading scorer in the playoffs with 5 goals and 2 assists. But Beislich, number 4, took it away, and now Ibrahim Silva to Costa. Costa, quick pass. Stojanovic, one-on-one with Werner Roy. And you see when they get the ball for Stojanovic, the crowd immediately reacts. Boy, this guy Costa is all over right now. He's really working after the ball, and they call him for a foul.
There is Costa pushing the ball out and also pushing Ross' legs out from underneath him. Free kick, New York.
Beckenbauer gives the ball to Hunter. Paul has a younger, an older brother, Tim, who's played in the league for 2 or 3 years, currently playing for Connecticut. The ball sent into Cosmos' zone, but Carlos Alberto able to take it. Takes it away from Stojanovic with a pass to Werner Raw. Now to Hunter. Hunter actually is a Canadian, born in Toronto, but he had the bulk of his schooling in Connecticut, Staples High School there, and was an All-American for the University of Connecticut. This is Garbutt, number 8, unsung hero of this ball club. He's undergone 4 knee operations, and a courageous story there. He's still playing as hard as he ever did. Stevie Hunt, right under the foot of Callahan, number 12, and Acosta comes out for the Lancers. Remember, the Cosmos have only won here one time. That was 2 years ago. Pass for Stojanovic went behind him and he slipped. There's been no rain here, but The forecast is for thundershowers later on. We hope that it will be a couple of hours at least later on.
There is no rain, but on the other hand, certain parts of this field are very slippery. Right near where they're playing now is a dark patch. I was walking out there earlier on, and moisture is squeezing out of that patch there. Very slippery there.
Going after the ball again, Costa. I'd say Costa has no fear out there.
Costa's getting into everywhere. I'm very impressed with Ross, the way he's playing Stojanovic so far. He's beating him to the ball.
Now this is Stevie Hunt. 2 goals, 4 assists. The only man in NASL history to have 3 assists in a playoff game. He did it against Tampa a week and a half ago. This is Tony Field. In the corner for Stevie Hunt. He's offside. The linesman on the far side made the call, or at least alerted the referee to it. From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer. Cole Gardner in Rochester, no score of the match, but the Cosmos on the attack. Remember, 1 week from today, 4 o'clock Eastern, 3 o'clock Central, the championship in North America. Canalia is offside. Grand made the save anyway, but Canalia was called offside. An interesting note here, when the Cosmos lost in Rochester a month ago, the Cosmos were caught offside 12 times in that ball game.
Yeah, well, I think Rochester do play, you know, an offside trap. They do try and move their backs up quickly when the ball comes through. They're moving in the opposite direction, hoping to catch one of the Cosmos players as Canalia there moving in the wrong direction, not looking.
Well, that's 3 offsides, and believe maybe 4 already in the Cosmos in this ball game. Paul, when a team starts getting caught offsides quite a bit, does that do something to them mentally, make them slow up or be more cautious?
It does something to them mentally. What it should do is make them change their game. It's no good pushing long balls through if you're going to be caught offside. You've either got to be more, play more attention or use short passing.
This is Gennady at midfield with Feislich on his back, and the Lancers able to get it out. Feislich starts it in. Quick chip for Stojanovic. Werner off right there. Crossing ball, but nobody's there in front. Messing comes out to grab it. Feislich finally did follow through, but nobody coming down the middle.
He looks dangerous, John Stojanovic, don't you think?
Oh, little bit. Ball sent in there by Ibrahim Silva, and there you get a look at some of the standing room only crowd here. Before the ball game, they had Operation Squeeze. So everybody get as close as you can together. That was Silva's shot.
Well wide.
So they say they could get 20,000 in here, but who knows how many we really have. They've got as many as they possibly can. Cosmos back on defense. Here comes Pedro down the middle. Fine playmaker right around Beckenbauer. Inside for Stojanovic. He's got it, but Alberto clears. Silva keeps it in the danger zone for the Lancers. Got Stojanovic in front. They'll always look for Stojanovic if possible. Silva with Beckenbauer on him. In the corner to Costa, the left wing. Costa around Garbutt, crossing pass, just cleared.
And that was Hunter again, who headed that ball behind for a corner. Very cool bit of play.
Well, the corner kick for Lancers.
Look at Costa going around Garbutt here. A lovely little right foot chip center over Carlos Alberto. Hunter is there, heads it behind for a corner. The safe thing to do, the wise thing to do.
John Pedro, number 10, will take it into the left wing corner. They'll set up on the penalty box. They've got Stojanovic in there. Holahan and Mijatovic come up for the back line, as does Don Dregi again. Bakic is in the middle, forward. So Pedro will try to put it on one of their heads. Low ball. Header by Bakic across the face of the net. And Dregi is the man who last touches it over the end line. So a Cosmos goal kick. 29-25 left, first half. No score in the match.
I think we've seen a bit of a change in momentum in the past few minutes. Rochester certainly attacking more strongly.
They met 2 times this year. The Cosmos won in New York 2-0. And Jack Brand made 19 saves in that game.
Now, I saw that game in New York. This is a very different Rochester team from what we saw in New York. In New York, they were lethargic and slow. They didn't seem to want to play particularly. Here, of course, another story altogether.
Well, Rochester won here a month ago, 1-0 on a shootout. Quick pass. Here goes Hunt. They call him offside again.
A flag up again. That must have been a very close thing. Very close call indeed.
Well, you must be behind 2 defenders in the goal line, or between you and the goal line, and they say if you're even with those defenders, you're not behind them. So it's a very iffy call.
No, it is, especially when the call has to be made at the time the ball is passed, not when it's received.
Moving in is Pedro, number 10. Bakic, Stojanovic, Silva in front, going for Silva, cleared by Beckenbauer. Comes to Bakic, number 9. Off for Costa, picked up by Hunter. Chip. Silva. over Ashford, but cleared by Beckenbauer. Then Garvin gets it out of the penalty area. Koster deflects it. Picked up by Escos. Koster is everywhere. Now Francisco Escos for Koster. Penalty area. Crossing pass in front. Shot! Goal! Stoyanovich! Mike Stoyanovich! And they're on their feet in Rochester, New York.
A beautiful goal, John. You can't ask for anything better than that. I think that was all made by Escos's pass. He gets the ball here and he pushes it through a maze of... Look how this ball comes through here. Right through three Cosmos players. Absolutely superb pass. And he's running into the area here. A lovely little chip over the defender. And there's Stoyanovich all on his own. And again, a very intelligent header. Messing moving to his left. Here we go. Koster's cross. Diving header from Stoyanovich. No chance for Messing. Beautiful goal.
So Mike Stoyanovich is the man, and it's 1-0 Rochester. From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
From Maine to California, you sit atop a rig with 13 forward speeds and 300.
Paul Gardner in Rochester, 1-0 is the score. We have 26:45 left in the first half. A week and a half ago when the Cosmos met Tampa in New York, Eddie Firmani said, the team that scores first will win. The Cosmos scored first and won, but Wednesday in Fort Lauderdale, the Strikers scored first, and still the Cosmos won. So we've got a lot of time left, a long way to go on this one, but Rochester has that first goal, and remember, their defense has not allowed a goal in the playoffs during three games. Koster in front, Stoyanovich again! Comes out to Escos. He fires, but he was off balance. Wide right, goal, Dick Cosmos.
Koster absolutely sort of ghosting his way through there. Nobody paying attention to him. He just breezed past here. And again, a lovely little cross. Floating down there. Trouble for the goalkeeper. In on Stoyanovich.
Well, Roth was staying with Stoyanovich early, but Stoyanovich has gotten free within 6 yards of the goal. Two times running now.
Gotten away twice, and he scored on once, and he's been very dangerous on the other.
Well, Rochester digs it loose at midfield again. Hunt chases after it, and the Cosmos get it. Beckenbauer sidesteps one, but loses. Bakic takes it for the Lancers. Leads it for Stoyanovich. He'll not catch up to it. Throw in Cosmos.
I think one of the reasons we can see here why Rochester are so difficult to score on is the speed with which they get back. You're going to see almost 10 men come back when the Cosmos come on the attack here.
No bonus points in a playoff, so win is a win. And there are two games to be played. If both teams win one, then Wednesday night in New York after that game, they'll have a 30-minute overtime minigame to determine the winner. So if the Cosmos lose here today, there'll be a lot of pressure in New York Wednesday. They have sold 65,000 tickets for that game already. So they're going to be gone quickly. If you want to go out there and you don't have tickets, you better get them right now. Wednesday night in New York. They had 78,000 or very nearly that last Sunday in New York. And that is a total sellout. Hunt couldn't get to it, and Greggy digs it loose. But now Moraes with a hard check that time gets it back for the Cosmos. For the ball is Stevie Hunt. Starting to rain a bit here in Rochester. Now field for Hunt in the corner, but Mijatovic is there to beat him to the ball. Dangerously blindsides it back to his goalkeeper. Hunt knocks it out of his hand, but they spotted it.
I think Hunt will get a talking to from the referee for that sort of unsportsmanlike conduct.
Going to get the yellow card.
He's getting more than a talking to.
Got the yellow card.
Very silly bit of stuff by Hunt. That it's just not necessary. Pelé is going to complain. He'll get a yellow card too if he's not careful.
Well, I guess
Mr. Hyatt is saying to Pelé, will you please go away, or worse to that effect. He's Scottish, in fact, Hyatt.
From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
How do you spell relief?
When I get acid indigestion, I...
And as we return to action, the Lancers have a corner kick in the left wing corner. We've got 23 minutes left in the first half. Stoyanovich scoring at 16:56. And Rochester leads 1-0. This is Pedro, number 10, in the corner kick. A long one. The header by Dreggy, number 2, the right fullback. And Shep Messing able to grab it easily.
They certainly are long corner kicks, these, John. I think every corner kick they've had now has come right over to the far side of the penalty area. Obviously, this is a tactic of theirs. It hasn't worked so far, but it'll be interesting to see if it does work in the future.
Foul there on Mike Bakic, number 9. Free kick for the Cosmos. The Cosmos, during the regular season, averaged just under 13 fouls committed per game. Rochester averaged about 20 fouls per ball game.
We're talking about fouls, John. Terry Garbutt in the Cosmos midfield is limping. He's not running well at all, and I think something's going to have to be done about this. He's clutching the back of his right thigh, and he does not look fit at the moment.
Rochester with the ball. Stojanovic loses it, but he lost it out of bounds first anyway. Throw in for the Cosmos. 1-0 Rochester. That's a dangerous kick on Escos and a free kick for the Cosmos. Pelé now comes up limping a little bit. Here comes Carlos Alberto into the attacking zone. Leads it ahead for Kinalia. Cleared by Mijatovic to Silva. Cosmos offense unable to penetrate at all. Quick counter-attacking pass. Stojanovic one-on-one with Roth, but he slips and falls.
Did he slip or was he pushed? He's claiming he was pushed. I think he slipped, though. But there again, see how dangerous that acceleration is? Roth, an awful, awful time trying to keep up with him there.
And, Paul, when we see Stojanovic alone like that, I guess that also is indicative of the fact they got so many people back.
We're going to see this a lot because they're bringing nine men back, and then these long balls, at that time it was a long pass by Silva, and Stojanovic with this explosive speed running onto it, and Roth is really going to have his hands full this afternoon.
Here comes Bakic with the ball deflected by Beckenbauer, and the Lancers are able to get it back. The Lancers are beating the Cosmos to the balls here early. Foul called there on a hunt for a high kick, a dangerous kick.
Well, Hunt's complaining about that. I think he has a point there because the 2 feet were up in the air, and I don't know why it should go against him.
Free kick for the Lancers. The Cosmos down 1-0 against a club that has not allowed a goal in, well, let's see, 300 minutes in the playoffs before today and another 24 minutes today. But the Cosmos have scored 28 goals in their last 7 games. That's 4 goals a game, including 8 against the league's best defensive club, Fort Lauderdale, last Sunday. So they've got the firepower to turn it on. This is Garbutt, number 8. Gives it for Hunter, goes behind him. Hunter tracks it down. Lancers putting everybody back again. They're all back there but Stojanovic. Pelé. Leads for Kinelli. He's got to beat Mijatovic, but Mijatovic cagily screens him off the ball, and Jack Brand is able to pounce upon it.
I would think Kinelli was a little bit upset that Pelé got to that ball, because if it had gone over Pelé's head, Kinelli was in a much better position to do something dangerous with it.
Got a steady rain right now in Rochester. They're sprouting the umbrellas here in upstate New York. Lancers on the attack. John Pedro around Beckenbauer. Lancers look very good. Correct there. This is Ibrahim Silva. Now to Costa in the corner. Jose Costa, crossing pass. Here's Stojanovic, the header, weak, and Messing gets up a rebound. But Alberto able to clear, and Hunter gets the ball out of the penalty area. But Callahan heads it back in, over the end line, and a Cosmos goal kick.
We'll look at that again as the ball comes over. Stojanovic header, and wide, Messing bobbling the ball.
From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
You deal with the Eastern Airlines, they're better.
The Lancers in white, the Cosmos in green, and Vito Dmitrievich, number 3, 5'10", 170, 4 goals and 6 assists, has come on for the Cosmos to replace the injured Terry Garbutt.
I don't know what this is going to do to the Cosmos, John, because Garbutt is a better defensive player than Dmitrievich. Dmitrievich is a better offensive player.
Got a free kick here for the Lancers. It's been their game up to now. The Cosmos offense has had no penetration at all.
Well, they've certainly been out-hustled by Rochester, who are playing as though their lives depend on this game, which in a sense they do. They have to win this game to stand a chance in the overall tie.
Stojanovic approaches, dumps it into the corner for John Pedro, number 10, crossing pass, Messing spikes it out of the box. Shot by Costa, knocked down by Werner Roth. Costa hustles for the rebound, and they say play on because Rochester has it. Knocked down by Hunter, but again Rochester has the loose ball. Callahan, number 12. He's got the big men in front. Low ball knocked down by Moraes, number 14, and the Cosmos start the counterattack. Here comes Field. Long pass for Kinalia, and Fazlic is right there. Kinalia loses to Fazlic.
I think the ball's gone out. Kinalia ran the ball out there.
It is, well,
no,
it's called a foul.
Foul on Fazlic.
So the Cosmos with a free kick. It is raining steadily. Field, top of the box, hustles after the ball. But again, the Lancers are able to beat him to it. They're getting these loose balls. Now Moraes for Tony Field. Back to Moraes, but
Stevie Hunt broke up the pass to his own man.
It's Stevie Hunt at the back. Murray's marvelous play there, defensive player. He took the ball away, and he never hesitated for a moment. He ran forward at full speed. If the ball had come to him, he must have had something dangerous to do with it.
Ibrahim Silva, 6 goals, 3 assists this year, the second leading scorer on the Lancers. Beat Toronto Wednesday night in the clinching game in Toronto with a goal. It's quite a feat to beat the defending league champions 2 games in a row. Now Silva is ahead of Dmitrievich. Alberto to help out, and Alberto, the World Cup veteran with a sure-footed tackle.
He's so cool, John. He really is. He's made several sort of situation-saving tackles already in this game, but as soon as he's done on the ball, he's never belted miles away anywhere. He gets up, he looks, and it's usually pushed to a teammate with such coolness. There goes Stevie Hunt.
Takes a pass from Beckenbauer. Feislitz, number 4, hustling back, and Feislitz is able to beat into the ball and get it into his goalkeeper. Jack Brand has had 3 consecutive shutouts in the playoffs. He had a 1.48 goals against in the regular season with 6 shutouts. And Rochester has won 5 of its last 6 games, and 4 of those Jack Brand shutouts. Hunt over the ball for Werner Roth. Again, the Cosmos have only won here once in 9 games in their history. Conversely, Rochester's won only 1 of 8 games in New York, where they'll play on Wednesday. Delay for Tony Field off his foot. They called him offside.
Again, that, offside.
That is the 5th offside on the Cosmos.
They're not sort of coping with this offside trap very well, are they?
And they didn't here a month ago when they got caught 12 times.
It'll be interesting to see now, Rochester one up, whether they'll continue to come at the Cosmos as they have been doing, or whether they'll sort of go back into a slightly more defensive shell now.
It's still raining in Rochester, 15:25 to go. Well, there will be no rain in Los Angeles tonight, I hope, at the Coliseum. Boy, that should be quite a game. The Aztecs, the highest scoring team in the league against the Seattle Sounders, a great defensive club. Got a foul here.
Great work by Stojanovic getting the ball away from 2 players. Gave it to Silva. Silva was knocked over by Beckenbauer. And Silva clutching his head and his knee. I don't think he quite make up his mind where he's hurt there.
34 yards from the goal line. Straight on. They'll set it up on this free kick. Silva dumps it off on the left side for Costa. Moves in on the rookie Hunter. Crossing pass. Coming on the blind side, and Steve Hunt clears it and gives up a corner kick for the Lancers.
Well, Steve Hunt, of course, an attacking player, not used to defensive duties. He did the safe thing there. At least you can't make a mistake on that sort of play, but he has given up a corner kick.
Pedro, as he has throughout the ball game, to put the ball in play on the corner kick. Stojanovic in front with Bakic, Palahan, and Mijatovic. Here's the high ball. Coming on the blind side, but Messing will grab it along the end line, and he made a mistake.
No, I think it was out. I think it was out before he got it. I think that's a goal kick. It curved out and then back in again.
We thought for a moment that they were saying that he lost it over the end line, but he kept the ball in. The feet can be out of bounds. It's where the ball is. So that was a Cosmos goal kick. 14 minutes left, first half. The Cosmos trailing by a goal to the Rochester Lancers, the Cinderella story of this year. Pass broken up by Palahan.
Again, look at all those white shirts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 white shirts. They're all within the space, all radius of about 20 yards.
And they put up the steel wall here with a goal lead. Stojanovic did his part, and now the defense is going into its act. And they call a foul here on the Cosmos. Pedro with the ball goes around Moraes, and Moraes trips him. Foul called.
I'm looking for a reaction.
Well,
from
getting
the referee. Yes, we are
card.
Getting a reaction. 2 yellow cards already for the Cosmos. They're doing what we thought Rochester might do. Collecting yellow cards.
Well, I guess down by a goal and playing against that kind of a defense, it gets frustrating as the day goes along. Every time you've got the ball, it seems like there are 2 members of the defense right on you.
That's certainly the way it's been up to at least 2.
Palahan with the ball for the Lancers. Sidesteps Kinalia. Leads it ahead for Bakic. Broken up by Tony Field. Palahan again. Inside. Silva there. And Beckenbauer wouldn't let him loose. Over the end line. Goal kick from Rochester. This is NASL Championship Soccer. outstanding player of this game will be selected by members of the Professional Soccer Writers Association covering the contest from the press box, and the player will receive from U.S. Tobacco the Copenhagen Skull Player of the Game Award and a check for $1,500 right after the ball game. Rochester leading 1-0 with the ball. Costa into the corner. Bumps Carlos Alberto, has the ball. Costa juking him into the penalty area, crossing pass just over the head of Stojanovic. Now Hunter just chips it into the air. Bakicek to the ball, comes out of the penalty area. Eskos drives in five, and Dmitrievich with the saving clear. Throw in Lancers.
Cosmos certainly living very dangerously down there indeed. That defense was in a terrible mess on those two crosses. Awful mess.
Now Pedro made an illegal throw in. He either took one of his hands off the ball or he raised up one of his feet.
He made an illegal throw and then he kicked the ball away, for which he might have expected to get a yellow card. He hasn't. Doesn't happen.
Cosmos have it. Cosmos have received two yellow cards. The Lancers were the club with the reputation. Here in Rochester, they billed them as winning the black and blue division. They had four men ejected in two playoff games, but the Cosmos have been the team that has been caught playing the rougher here today. Now Stevie Hunt driving into the attacking zone, but he loses the ball. He had field in front of him. The way he reacted afterward, it looked as though he meant to pass the ball to field. But
I think he was annoyed with field for running in front of him. He felt he took the ball away from him.
Costa can't control it. Number eight for the Lancers, the Cosmos. Alberto gets it out. Cosmos trying to get the offense going, but the Lancers haven't given them room to do it. We've got 10 minutes left. First half, 1-0 Rochester. Dmitrievich to Paul Hunter, the right fullback, moving into the attack. Hunter in front for Kinalia. Chip or headed by Fazlic. Belay back for Kinalia. Fazlic knocks it down. Hunter or Steve Hunt with a chip. Kinalia after it. Spiked out by Jack Brand. Goes out of bounds. Throw in Cosmos. Now into Pelé. Pelé double team, triple team. Ends up at his back. No foul. Silva. Counter-attacking pass for Stojanovic. But Werner Roth able to intercept the ball. Drops it back in his own zone for Alberto. The Cosmos in the season were 5-8 on the road, including losing their last six consecutive games in the road. Meanwhile, they have won 10 games in a row at home. Here's Pelé. Dreggy's there, and the young American can't take it away from him. Pelé slips, gets the ball to Hunt. Kinalia, field in the penalty area. Crossing pass for Tony Field, but Callahan heads it away. Let's just get it out to Pedro. He's off to the races. That's Stojanovic ahead. Double teamed, and Hunter is able to knock the ball loose to Dmitrievich. 8:50 left, first half. Beckenbauer for Stevie Hunt. Hunt, 2 goals, 4 assists in the playoffs. 8 goals, 10 assists, regular season. 12th leading scorer in the league. Tony Field moves in. He's faking. Still, oh, blindsided by Costa. And back to the goalkeeper. Jack Brand, a member of the Canadian Olympic team at the Montreal Olympics in 1976, played in the NASL for Toronto previously under an amateur contract. So I guess if a player doesn't want to get paid, they'll oblige him.
I think the club will be only too delighted.
Nelson Moraes to the ball to midfield. Starts it into the attack. Goes by Eskos. He's got Kinalia in front. Moraes still moving into the penalty box. And a weak shot is Fazlic. Angled into the outside.
That was a good effort by Moraes, a fullback coming all that way. Almost as though he's a defender saying, well, if the forwards can't do it, I'll show him how it should be done. Which he did until he shot. The shot was weak, but the run was good.
Upfield for Stojanovic, number 7. He's got the game's only goal. And Roth. Well, Stojanovic is outnumbered every time he gets the ball, as he's the only man back there for the Rochester Lancers. Cosmos with it with 7.5 minutes left in the first half. Trailing 1-0, Tony Field. Stevie Hunt ahead for Kinalia, moving in, but intercepted by Fazlic. Lancers get it out to Bakic on the right wing. The rain is falling. I don't know if you can see it at home. It's not a real heavy rain, but it's a steady downpour. Field is slippery. Here comes Callahan. In the corner, Silva. Picked up by Alberto. Stojanovic works in front of the goal. Silva tries to get it to him. Silva still with the ball. looking for an opening. Beckenbauer bumps him. Silva still moving. And finally, Hunter clears it to midfield.
A bit of an example of a player really dribbling too much there. He should have given that ball off. He had Costa outside him on the left in a much better position. He just dribbled into trouble with that.
Here comes John Pedro, number 10, into the danger zone across that 35. Lateral pass in the middle for Escos. Canalla beats him to it. Escos is grabbing Canalla around the midsection there, but Giorgio, the big bear, maintains the ball. Pelé back to Canalla. And Giorgio, like Phil Esposito in hockey, tough man to take that ball away from.
He did very well to hang on to that ball then because Escos was snapping at his heels throughout the entire time of that play.
Steve Hunt back to Vito Dmitrievich. Dmitrievich has been out with an injury for quite a while. Now Alberto for Hunter on the right side. Hunter moves in against Callahan, number 12. Now Costa to help out. Hunter loses the ball, but Costa called for a foul. Free kick, Cosmos. Inside 6 minutes left in the first half. Quick pass for Pelé. Makes the chest trap. He's got Escos in his back. Looks for an opening. May have found it. Shoves it off. A shot. Oh, Field miskicked it. Comes to Canalla. Looks for an opening. Flying shot. He scores!
That was a really good goal by Canalla. Nobody's going to complain about that one. A nice assist from Pelé and getting the ball across. A beautiful turn by Canalla to make that shot. Let's have a look at that again. Oh, we're not seeing too much of it there. That's the shot and it's going in there. But that really was a superb turn by Canalla. We're seeing it started with Carlos Alberto's pass here. We see Paul Hunter here lose the ball. I think Carlos Alberto taking a free kick here very quickly, puts it down. As soon as he takes his hand off the ball, he's pushed forward. Pelé, a chest trap outside him, a lovely little turn here, pushes the ball behind his standing leg, across the middle there to Tony Field trying to shoot, misses. Canalla turns, puts the ball in, but Brandt coming out there, and Canalla got it under him. Very good goal by Canalla. We've had two excellent goals up to now.
That is the sixth goal of the playoffs for Giorgio Canalla. And he now stands alone as the leading scorer in playoff history. And he's done it all in, well, 3.5 games. Pelé was tied with Canalla for leading scorer in NASL playoff history. And now Canalla has passed him. I don't know if they'll give Pelé an assist on that or not.
I think they'll give Pelé, they must give Pelé on field assists, I think.
Shep Messing takes the ball away here. We have 5:10 showing on the scoreboard clock, the unofficial clock.
Well, I say they must give Pelé. I've been wrong on assists constantly throughout the season here, so I better not say that or I'll screw them up.
Steve Hunt with the ball to midfield, but it's dug loose by Don Reggie. Now here comes Costa, Jose Costa, as the Lancers' 1-0 lead is evaporated. He's got Stojanovic in a penalty area in front if he can beat Hunter, but Alberto, the sweeper, back to help out. Costa gets up, but Hunter is there to knock him off the ball. They fight after it down there, and a foul is called on Jose Costa. From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
Jeremy, do you know what sound
is? Stadium in Rochester, New York, the stadium that is the focal point of soccer today and has more people in it than ever before. As you see, Giorgio Canalla has just got his sixth goal of the playoffs and now has scored in every game of the playoffs. He really was a heroic figure in Fort Lauderdale. They were getting ready to go into that 30-minute minigame, almost conceding the game to the Lancers, and Canalla scored with about 5 minutes to go to tie it up. And they eventually won it in a shootout. Here's Ibrahim Silva, but Dmitrievich clears it on a header. Callahan tries to keep it in, but Dmitrievich clears it out. Comes to Miralem Fazlic, moving up. Lancers moving up more on offense now that it's tied. Here's Stojanovic, one-on-one with Werner Roth. The foul goes against Stojanovic.
That cannot be classed as a popular decision here, John. An instant uproar from the crowd here. As the ball comes in, they both go for the ball here. Well, we really can't see from that angle what's going on.
The Cosmos have come down the field while we were looking at the replay, and Stevie Hunt has scored a goal. The Cosmos have taken the lead. Stevie Hunt has scored. We'll get a look at it right here.
We've got a Pelé coming down the left side here, a very long ball. Hunt, and again, it's this offside trap. Oh, a terrible mistake by Mijatovic. Confusion between him and the goalkeeper. Stevie Hunt left with an open net to put it in.
So Stevie Hunt has scored a goal for the Cosmos.
Here's Mijatovic. He really trying, I don't know what he was trying to do there, whether he's trying to give it to Brandt And there's Stevie Hunt with his left leg just dragging the ball so that he can get his shot on and put it into the net.
That is the third goal of the playoffs for Stevie Hunt. And he is the second leading scorer of all players in the playoffs. George Best is in third place for the LA Aztecs. So the Lancers, the defense which had been so hard to score against, well, almost gives one away.
They've given up twice as many goals in the space of 15 minutes here as they have in the whole playoffs up to now.
2 minutes left in the first half, so now the Cosmos have a 2-1 lead. Steve Hunt, a young player, an excitable player, but a guy who puts the ball in the net.
Yeah, he did very well on that. Looking at on that replay there, he kept his balance beautifully to get that ball, to get his shot off into the net.
Pelé.
Well, we don't see
his footing, loses it out of bounds.
We don't see that too often. Well, somebody else missed it. There must be something about nasty little deceptive patch of ground there.
Here's a ball for Stojanovic. He and Werner Roth after it. Werner will clear it. Speaking of Pelé, he has scored almost a goal a game in 22 years. If you were to translate that into, say, the space of a hockey season, he would have the equivalent of 76 goals a year for 17 years. Look out, here's Buckets in front. Marais clears. Eskos tries to keep it in. He does! Acosta in the left wing. It's got Silva, Stojanovic, and Dregi, the header! Left goal kick Cosmos.
Another of those dangerous crosses from Costa. Dragi was up there, he had his header, but he put it high and wide.
53 seconds left in the match, or in the first half rather. At halftime, we'll take a look at the playoffs as they are right now with four teams left in the running. There's a foul on Don Dragi, number two, over the back of Kinalia. And we'll also take a look at those eight goals the Cosmos got last Sunday. That's an all-time playoff record that could stand for a long time. Here comes Tony Field into the danger zone. Leads it off, intended on the open wing for Dmitrievich, intercepted by Silva, and Rochester has it. You see the time remaining in the first half. Time for a rush for the Lancers, who now trail 2-1. Here comes Silva. Dmitrievich able to clear it to Carlos Alberto. And that may be it if the Cosmos can hold it for the first half. That time is unofficial. The referee keeps the official time on the field. He blows the whistle, and the first half has come to an end. The end of the first half of play with a score. The Cosmos 2, the Rochester Lancers 1. We'll return in a moment with our exciting halftime show. Halftime from Rochester, and time for a bit of a retrospective on these 1977 playoffs. A few surprises. None of the division winners are in the semifinal rounds. It all began in the Atlantic Conference. First of all, the Cosmos in the Eastern Division with a two-game sweep of Fort Lauderdale, the latter game in a shootout down in Florida. A big upset. Third place Rochester, a two-game sweep over Toronto, winning the last game in Toronto despite having two men ejected. Out west in the Western Division, Minnesota, first-place finisher, surprised by third-place Seattle in two games, and first-place Dallas, surprised by second-place Los Angeles in two games. So tonight, 7 o'clock, the Coliseum, Los Angeles opens up against the Seattle Sounders, and then on Wednesday, game two of this series, Rochester at the Meadowlands against the Cosmos, and then Thursday night, 7:30 at the Kingdome, Seattle and L.A. wrap it up. And finally, Soccer Bowl 77 right here on TVS next Sunday at 4 o'clock. Well, when soccer is playing well, played as a team, it's like a finely orchestrated symphony. And the Cosmos certainly proved that last Sunday with their 8-3 victory over Fort Lauderdale. The symphony was in fine form for the Cosmos, as we'll see right here. The Cosmos got the first goal a minute 37 into the match off the foot of Stevie Hunt. Nice shot. Kenaya Pelé with assists. Little did the Strikers, with the best defensive record in the league, know the Avalanche had hardly begun. Again, Hunt starting the play. Beckenbauer working with Field. And finally, all Beckenbauer. Look at this. 3 men around him by the goalkeeper. Beautifully done. 2-0 Cosmos. And then Kinalia working with Beckenbauer. And the Big Bear not to be denied on this beautiful play by Beckenbauer. a 10-man blanket just to keep up with Beckenbauer. After Whittle made it 3-1, the Cosmos back again with Stevie Hunt. Great individual effort. Cosmos. That's the way the first half ended. Then in the second half, Tony Field off to the races. On the short side, assist Alberto and Roth. 5-1 Cosmos. Then Giorgio Chinaglia with his second goal of the day. On the rebound, he's got a hustle. Giorgio doesn't miss those. 6-1 Cosmos. But Chinaglia is not finished. He's going for the record. Nobody's ever scored a hat trick in the playoffs. Until right there. Hat trick for Chinaglia. 7-1 Cosmos. And finally, no record on the line, but an 18-year-old from Annandale, Virginia, scoring in the playoffs. You think Gary Etherington is excited? Yes. 8-3 Cosmos, all-time record for goals scored, and best of all, an all-time crowd. For the Cosmos and their fans, a day to remember. We'll be back with more Halftime from Rochester in a moment. United States World Cup and Olympic teams has been with us a couple of times this year as our guest commentator. Walt is also into making films these days. We saw one he made last week. Let's go now to Walt Chisowitz again, movie star.
Now here is Walter Chisowitz, national coach for the United States Soccer Federation.
People have asked me, what are my objectives and aims as a national coach in the development of soccer players for the Americans? This is not very easy to answer, but for sure, we're looking for some quality players. They can only come through the large number of youngsters that are playing around the country. And from there, we can bring in the quality into our international teams. We have three international teams. One is the United States National Youth Team. The other one is the United States Olympic Team, which competes both in the Olympics as well as the Pan American Games. And finally, our professional team, the United States World Cup team. These three teams are the national teams representing the United States every year in different competitions. We hope to get the best quality players and build from those youngsters playing now. We're looking for our coaches to find them, to let us know about them, and then we'll invite them to our training camps, like the United States Olympic Training Center in Squaw Valley. We feel very confident that with these players, we can be competitive internationally and have some success against the likes of England, Italy, or Germany, or Russia, or whatever. But for sure, the youngsters that are playing now should continue, because we're going to look at them. If I not personally, then our staff coaches around the United States will be looking at these players, so all of you can get involved. Coca-Cola has been involved in making many things happen for the United States Soccer Federation. They have developed a Kick Me contest, the first nationwide contest ever to be held in the United States related to soccer itself. And there are different skills where youngsters must perform and show their abilities. One is heading. He must be able to juggle the ball with his head as many times as possible without allowing the ball to drop. Another one is juggling with the foot. With the instep, he must be able to maintain the ball in the air without allowing it to drop, and the highest number of repetitions, that one will become the winner. Another one is alternating feet and juggling, left, right, keeping the ball in the air with the instep.
Be sure and watch for the Kick Me contest finals during halftime of the NASL championship game next Sunday.
Championship Soccer is brought to you by Toyota. You asked for soccer and you got it. Thanks to Toyota, makers of quality cars and trucks. Toyota, the official car of the NASL. And by the people in your town who also bring you the bright, refreshing taste of Coca-Cola. Coke adds life to just about everything you do. And by the Miller Brewing Company, makers of light beer. Everything you always wanted in a beer. And less.
Boy, I'd love that Celica. But what I need is a truck.
You asked for it. Toyota's SR5 long bed sport truck.
Hot dog.
Gutsy 2.2-liter engine. Power-assisted front disc brakes. High back bucket seats. Five speeds. Radials. Car-like ride. The Toyota sport truck. For a truck, it's upset. Wheels. If you can find a better built truck than Toyota, buy it.
You got it, Toyota.
Sure, Schick loves my face, and your face too. Terrific shaves are their business, right? But right now, Schick is making it their business to love these faces, my kids. Send Schick proof of purchase of any Schick blades. They'll donate 50 cents to our muscular dystrophy campaign, give you a 50 cent refund, and a great shave. So when you go to your store and buy Schick blades, here's what happens. You get a terrific shave, and my kids get the money. Thank you, Schick. Thank you.
When you're like John White, the sportsman and world-famous men's fashion designer, you don't just smoke a cigar, you wear it. That's why John White designed a cigar for men like himself. Capitan. He styled the pack, bands, and four shapes to flatter your looks, while tobacco experts combined African Cameroon wrapper and mild imported filler to flatter your taste. Try Capitan by John White. See how good good looks can taste.
And then the rains came, and it is still coming, coming heavier than ever here in Rochester. As you can see, the fans huddling up and trying to keep themselves as dry as possible, but nobody's left Hollander Stadium in Rochester, New York. It's 2-1 at halftime. Rochester scoring first and a goal by Stojanovic. Then Kinalia scored from Pelayan Field, and Hunt scored from Pelayan, a Rochester defensive mix-up. 2-1 Cosmos. Rochester with a slight advantage in the shots. Messing with three saves, Brand has made one. And Rochester with five corner kicks to only one for the Cosmos. Despite Paul Cosmos' lead, I would say that probably Rochester still had the best of it offensively.
Yeah, I think they did, and the statistics show it, and I'm sure in the second half we're going to see a lot more attacking from Rochester. They're a goal down, and I think they play better when they are attacking. They played their best soccer before they scored their goal. As soon as they got the goal, they did. The edge went out of their play. They became a bit more defensive. The Cosmos have got back into the game. They tied it, and now on a rather, in a sense, rather lucky goal, a bit of bad luck for the Rochester defence, they've gone ahead 2-1. Rochester now have to come out and attack. They have to play the first half all over again.
We've got a driving rain here right now. The going's going to be slippery, maybe muddy in a few places. Does that give an advantage to perhaps the defence over the offence or vice versa?
No, I don't really think it gives an advantage to anybody. I think the ball is going to slip and do odd things, and this could work in favour or it could work against either side.
There's Frank O'Doy, number 17, starting the second half for Rochester. O'Doy, an original member of this ball club, and he played in the NASL Championship game 1970. Look out, Stojanovic!
Very quick to turn around. He beat Roth on the turn that time. Messing was quick to come out and smother the ball.
So Frank O'Doy is at midfield for the Rochester Lancers, and that is the only substitution, I believe. He's come in for Mike Bakic, or has he? Yes, he has. Bakic has gone out, and the Lancers now with Frank O'Doy, a man who, well, he played in the ball club that won the league championship in 1970. Lancers defense able to get the ball out of there, and here they come as they start attacking, as Paul Gardner predicted they would. Beckenbauer at midfield now with the Cosmos. The scoreboard clock is not working now in the second half, so we'll do our best to keep you abreast as to the time.
Of course, John, predicting that Rochester will attack wasn't sort of... I don't have to be too bright to say that, because they are a goal down. The question is what the Cosmos will do. Will they continue to attack, or will they now drop off a bit because they're a goal ahead?
Well, they're attacking now. Dmitrievich to Hunt. Oh, he goes around O'Doy. Takes a shot, and Brand dives after it, but the linesman had raised the flag across the way, and he had spotted an offside in the Cosmos.
It's not a Pele offside. And I think you saw there a bit of the problems you're likely to have with the rain. Brent went down for that ball, but he was very uncertain, and the ball skimmed through. It comes off the turf very quickly when it's wet.
Six offsides against the Cosmos now, none for Rochester. Here's Jose Costa moving into the danger zone on the left wing. Hunter rides the ball away from him. Roth helps out. Cosmos claimed that it bounced off Costa over the end line.
Yeah, I think the referee agrees with them. I think they're going to get a corner kick out of this.
The Cosmos are going to set it up for a goal kick, but the referee is going to give them a foul.
Well, there we are.
Foul called on either Hunter or Roth, and a free kick.
Presumably on Hunter, John.
Just outside of the penalty area. Again, we're going to have to guess at the time. We've got about 2 or 3 minutes gone here in the second half. Pedro is over the ball, number 10 in the left wing, along with Costa, number 8, and Costa now alone over the ball. A lot of jockeying in front. Drops it short for Pedro. Cross in front for Stojanovic. Spiked down by Messing, and Moraes clears it out. It will go out of bounds near midfield. Well, the Lancers creating a dangerous situation that time. Beckenbauer picks up the loose ball, and the Cosmos have it, leading 2-1. Crucial game. The Cosmos with 10 straight wins at home. So Rochester really has to win this ball game today.
A spectacular interception there by Roth. He got up well on that ball, followed it back, didn't get it clear, though. It's still with Rochester.
Francisco Escos, Pancho with the ball. All-leaguer, 72 and 73. He's got O'Doy ahead of him. Goes to O'Doy. Frank O'Doy, one goal, three assists for the year. Now the Cosmos intercept, and the Cosmos had a lot of men back defensively that time. Here they come. Pele, the Black Pearl, with two assists in this ball game. 3 goals, 3 assists now for the playoffs. Ahead for Field. Takes it away from Escos, but loses to Mijatovic. And back to the goalkeeper, Jack Brand. Roll it out on the left wing for Callahan. And the Lancers down by a goal with a lot of time left. Callahan, who was a forward in college, is actually drafted on the recommendation of Terry Hansen, now the PR director for Washington, who was up here in Rochester. Had seen him play in college. He told Dragan Popovich, this is the guy to get. They drafted him first, made him a fullback, and he's played extremely well for them. Ibrahim Silva now. Crossing ball in front, missing, has to play it on a hop. With Stojanovic right there. Slippery going. You worry about a goalkeeper here losing the ball on a rebound. Get a look at it right here.
And he goes around, my God, he gets those crosses in well, because that was a very difficult angle, and of course he was moving at speed. Turn the ball through 90 degrees like that on a slippery field. That's some doing.
Live action here, Pele. Going to be called for obstruction there with John Pedro.
Rather vigorous obstruction that was. Two behinds clashing, two number 10s too, as a matter of fact.
Callahan over the ball. High chip. And it'll be intercepted by the Cosmos. Just gave it away. Stevie Hunt, who has the tie-breaking goal right now for the Cosmos. And here comes Beckenbauer. Long one for Tony Field. Over to pick him up is Foslich. Field moves in now into the danger zone. In the middle for Canalia. Has Pelé on the right side. Georgia looking for an opening. To Field, a shot! And he misses wide left from Rochester. This is NASL Championship Soccer. Jose Costa in the left wing corner. Corner kick for the Rochester Lancers, who trail by a goal in the second half. Low ball for Stojanovic. Pelé out of the box. Comes to Pedro. Back inside for Dreggy. Look out! A shot by Silva over the bar. Goal kick Cosmos.
Very sloppy play by Pelé there. Amazing that he pushed the ball out and he pushed it straight onto the feet of John Pedro. And he had plenty of time to do something more constructive than that with it.
Shep Messing, the former All-American from Harvard, member of the U.S. national team, led the league in goals against average in 1975 as a bit of a viral infection. He felt a little bit weaker than usual. Not that he's usually weak. Felt less than 100% last night and has not been working out the last couple of days to try and get over it. Felt well enough to play today. This is Callahan. Lateral pass. Escos pushes it off to Dreggy. The fullback's really pushing up. The outside fullbacks. Stevie Hunt with a sliding tackle. Rochester throw-in. Dreggy, All-American from St. Louis, their first draft choice this year. Now Miralem Pazlic inside for Escos. Escos for Dreggy. Skatstojanovic Silva inside. His attempted cross deflected by Beckenbauer. Odoi has it. Frank Odoi, the veteran, knocked away by Steve Hunt to Canalia. Canalia has it cleared by Foslic. Nice hustle by Canalia. Tell you, he's had kind of an in-and-out sort of a season, but he's really saved the best for last.
He has.
In the playoffs.
He's had a very disappointing season during the regular season. But, in fact, since Eddie Fermani came to the team, he's really been playing much better, and he's done brilliantly in the playoffs.
Here comes Steve Hunt. He'll cut a long one from outside. Wide right. Rochester goal kick. From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
Here's your car battery. Add water. Keep it clean. It lasts an average of 38 months. Here's the battery that will make yours obsolete. The JCPenney battery. It started a revolution in car batteries. You never have to add water. It's so powerful, it's fully warranted for as long as you own your car. If it fails, return it. We'll replace it free. Only at JCPenney Auto Centers or catalog desks. It's the last battery your car will ever need.
When you have a headache, what does extra strength mean to you?
It means your headache's going to stop hurting. It means Excedrin.
It means your headache's going to go away fast. It means Excedrin.
It means relief that lets you feel like, well, like smiling again. And that definitely means Excedrin.
Excedrin. With more pain reliever, more total strength than regular strength aspirin and non-aspirin tablets. For millions of people, extra strength means Excedrin.
It means Excedrin.
Rochester with a ball. John Miller, Paul Gardner at Hollander Stadium. Get a look at the final tally for the Most Valuable Player Award is voted by the players. the line second, and Steve David and George Best of Los Angeles in there. David, who had a marvelous year, 26 goals, and George Best, who tied Pelé's assist record. And George Best has really had a great playoff series as well, and they'll be in action at the Coliseum in L.A. tonight against Mickey Cave and Tommy Ord and the Seattle Sounders. That should be a great game to see. Steve David, unfortunately, out for the year with ligament damage, but Best and Charlie Cook and Bacos and Martin Cohen, Annie Mihailovic, they found other men to take up the slack. Foul there on Frank Odoi, number 17 of Rochester. Free kick for the Cosmos.
See, what a difficult man to knock off bounce. Nelson Marais says he was being fouled every which way there, and yet he kept his feet and he kept control of the ball.
Cosmos have it. Franz Beckenbauer. Kaiser Franz. This guy's been in a lot of big games. Warner Roth for the ball. Has to chase it. Look out. Costa almost took it away. Costa still hustling here. Now Tony Field. Tony Field, five game-winning goals the last 2 years for the Cosmos. A clutch player. Long ball for Pelé. Callahan deflects. Escos. Odoi. Here comes Odoi. 32-year-old veteran. Moving in against the rookie Hunter. Into the danger zone. Scott Stojanovic perched in the penalty box in front of the net, but goes outside to Pedro. Now Escos to Odoi. Outside to Pedro. Lateral pass for Fazlic, moving in on the attack. Looks ahead for Stojanovic. Goes for Stojanovic. Goes behind him, and Roth tries to clear and slices it off his foot, but the Cosmos get it. Now, would that be attributable partly to the slippery going?
I think that was, yeah.
A week from today, be with us. Don't miss it. Soccer Bowl 77 at Multnomah Stadium in Portland. And, boy, they've got great fans out there that make a big noise. One of these ball clubs against either Los Angeles or Seattle. And if you're down in Southern California, make your plans to be at the Coliseum tonight, 7 o'clock. A very entertaining club, those Aztecs. A high-flying, high-scoring, attacking club with a great player, George Best, against the Seattle Sounders. Should be a great game, and the Aztecs will need to win. At midfield, Lancers to the ball. Costa, 2-1 Cosmos. By our count, we've got about 32 minutes left in the match. Foul there on Nelson Marais, number 14. And again, just a word of advice for those of you in New York. As of sometime today, they had already sold 65,000 seats for the game Wednesday at New York. And Pelé's final game, October the 1st against Santos, is all sold out. Here comes Drecke inside. Dimitrievich deflects the ball over the head of Silva. And the Cosmos are able to clear it out. The Lancers really pushing forward here. Hunt, long counter-attacking pass. Canalia, foot race with Mijatovic. Canalia wins the race. He's got the ball. Pelé moving in the middle to help out. Here's a centering ball for Pelé. And Fazlic is able to break it up. Canalia with good hustle, and Pelé followed it up. Now Pedro, the counter-attack. Long ball for Stojanovic, but he's offside. The linesman raised the offside flag, but the referee said no offside, so give the ball to Rochester. Referee said, no, I'll make that call, and he's not offside. So the Lancers still have not been called offside in this ball game. Here's a foul on Costa. Jim Hyatt, the referee. Now Tony Field on the right wing for the Cosmos. Field assisted on the first goal, sort of a roundabout fashion, but it worked. Got the result. Hunt at midfield, gives the ball off to Carlos Alberto. Veteran sweeper back ahead for Pelé. Here come the Cosmos. Quinalla is along with him. Pelé tries to go through the defense, but Fazlic is able to take it away. The Rochester counterattack. They need a goal, trailing by one, and Beckenbauer there to knock it down. Moraes tries the acrobatic bicycle kick. Not quite. Here's Ibrahim Silva for Stojanovic. Back heel for Silva. Silva looks for an opening. He's got Alberto on him. And finally, Alberto clears. Here comes Pedro. The Lancers keep the pressure on. Pedro, the high crossing ball, deflected by Alberto. Comes to Moraes. He clears it out. But again, the Lancers right back in. Escos to Pedro, looking for the tying goal. In toward the net was Stojanovic moving in. And Messing is just able to take it away. The pressure is off.
A lot of pressure there from Rochester, but I just don't think they're putting enough men up there. They had three fullbacks back and two men in midfield, which means they only had They only have five men up. I don't think that's enough, John. I think they've got to throw more people forward than that.
Well, Eskos and Odoi at midfield are not really known as offensive type players.
I think they've got to try and make like offensive play.
Now Pele at midfield for the Cosmos. Kinaya went down, and he's
heavy,
a little slow
from
in getting
Kozlic,
up.
Yeah. That's the euphemism we use, isn't it, when he has a broken leg? A little slow in getting up here.
Bit shaken up. Ball was dug loose at midfield, and Nelson Moraes has it. Ahead for Kinaya. And he looks like he's all right now.
Yes, he's certainly quick in getting up on that one.
Back to Stevie Hunt. Hunt goes around Pedro. Nicely done. Now in the left wing, here's Tony Field alone. Kinaya, Pele in front. High cross. And over the bar, over the end line. Goal kick for the Rochester Lancers.
Lovely little moves by Steve Hunt to get that ball out to Field.
Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
Teleprompter, the nation's largest cable television company, demonstrates their reception. They obviously want their picture to look as good as it possibly can. Out of all the television sets in the country, guess which one they use? Exclusively. That's right. It's a Sony.
John Miller, Paul Gardner, and we'll see a week from today, 4 o'clock, one of these teams against one of the teams that will be playing tonight in Los Angeles for Soccer Bowl 77. Rochester still with the advantage in shots, and Messing now has been credited with 5 saves in the ball game. Rochester with 6 corner kicks to 1 for the Cosmos. So indicative of the Lancers have still had more offensive thrusts than have the Cosmos. Here comes New York now trying to get the offense going. Threading the needle with a pass for Pele, but was too fine, and Fizlitz comes out with it. Here come the Lancers on the attack. Silva, Stojanovic ahead, but Stevie Hunt with a nice blindside tackle. Now Kinalia digs the ball loose, but gives it up to Odoi. Odoi for Costa, Jose Costa, in across the 35. Inside, Odoi, open for a moment. Beckenbauer, Alberto, or Moraes get confused. Now back to Pedro. John Pedro moves in. Tries to feed it inside, knocked down by Moraes. Hunt comes out with it. Nice hustle. Here comes Pele to Stevie Hunt. Hunt has scored the tie-breaking goal. Look out! Kinalia all alone tries! Looks like a handball outside of the box. Oh,
I think it was.
The referee now calls a foul on the Cosmos. It looked like
Brand was outside the box on that.
We'll get a look at it here.
I think we'll see this long ball from Stevie Hunt. A terrible defensive mix-up. Canalia chasing it. Brandt is outside the area. That little arc there doesn't count. That's not part of the area. That should have been a free kick to the Cosmos for handling outside the area.
Well, now, is it possible he didn't hit it with his hand, that he bounced it out with his body?
It's possible. From what I saw, it looked like he hit it with his hand.
I thought he did, too. But the men in black in the field all said no. Pass for Pele. Pele almost around Fizlitz, into the box, and Brand comes out. The outstanding player of this game will be selected by the members of the Professional Soccer Reporters Association. Covering the contest, the player will receive from U.S. Tobacco the Copenhagen Skoll Player of the Game Award and a check for $1,500. That also will be in effect next week at Soccer Bowl 77. Here's Jose Costa moving in against Hunter toward the penalty area. He's into the penalty box. Goes around him, tries to cross. Here's Silva, shot! Hits the side of the net!
Silva clutching his head in dismay. A good opportunity there. Beautiful run by Costa.
From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
I had my own way of tackling. I used to grab the whole backfield. Then I threw guys out until I found the one with the ball. When I started drinking beer, I did the same thing. And this is the one I'm holding on to. Light beer from Miller. It has a third less calories than the regular beer. It's less filling, and it tastes terrific, too. I also love the easy opening can.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Come on, honey, come on. We're getting our picture taken.
Special moments. Times of your life you'll want to remember in pictures.
Smile, Howard. Smile.
To help make those pictures look as good as they can, make sure Kodak paper is behind them. If you don't see these words, it isn't Kodak paper. Just look for this sign when you get your pictures. Kodak paper, for a good look at the times of your life.
Wasn't that fun?
Here's a look at that last near chance at goal for Rochester.
That is the ball being run into the area there.
Meanwhile, back to live action. They really move the game with a pass to Stojanovic. But the linesman, you saw his flag at the bottom of your screen. For the first time, the Lancers are caught offside. Well, the Lancers have shown that they can create the chances in this ball game. Now Beckenbauer loses it to Escos. Ibrahim Silva in the middle. Silva tackled by Dimitrievich and a foul call on Vito. They're in L.A. tonight at 7 o'clock now. The Sounders and the Aztecs. Then on Thursday at the Kingdome in Seattle. They've already sold about 23,000 tickets for that game. You better get them in a hurry. Here's a goal kick for the Cosmos as Costa loses it over the end line. So Wednesday night at the Meadowlands, this series will end up. That one about 12 or 13,000 away from being sold out. And they really expect a huge crowd in Seattle Thursday night as L.A. and Seattle ended. They had 42,000 in Seattle last Wednesday. That'll be the biggest game in Seattle Sounder history. They've got a lot of great friends up, fans up there in the Northwest. Well, we're in the second half, and we've got about 22 or 23 minutes to go in the ball game, and it's 2-1 Cosmos, and the Lancers desperately trying to get the equalizer here at home. Ball inside for Ibrahim Silva. Oh, he's submarined by Moraes. The referee says no foul. Moraes comes out hurting a little bit, favoring the left ankle. Cosmos started out. Carlos Alberto. Long one for Pelé. Look out. Pelé after the ball takes a quick hop off the turf. And Jack Brand is able to get it within the confines of the penalty area. Playoff attendance all around this year is up. About 28,000 a game is the average for the playoffs. Here's a quick ball in the corner for Silva. Moraes saw it, clears it. Cosmos have set up a pretty effective defensive wall of their own right now.
Yeah, they are playing a bit more defensively. Well, of course, they're one goal up, and it's to be expected. But that sort of caution can lead you into trouble. The momentum does go to the other team. They get the equalizing goal, and then you've got a heck of a job to get back into the game.
Pass to midfield for Canalia. It's a bit awry and intercepted by Fuzlich. And the Lancers will start it in again, needing one goal. Trailing 2-1. Nice tackle by Moraes away from Silva. Comes to Fuzlich. Lancers moving it in again. Quick pass for Stojanovic. The gunner has the goal for Rochester. Tries to go around Werner Rohr. Crossing ball in front of
it was missing right in the right position at the right time. Stojanovic getting around Ross. Beautifully, a lovely cross, near post cross.
We'll get a look at it here.
There is Stojanovic, traps the ball, moves around Roth, barges him off the ball, right foot cross, and there is Odoi to head that ball, but messing right in the right position, straight through.
Frank Odoi, who got loose that time, and Stojanovic put it right there. 2-1, the Cosmos still with the lead, but the Lancers two or three times have made a serious threat. Dimitrievich ridden off the ball, and Dimitrievich finally loses it out of bounds. Throw in Rochester. From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
makes you live it nice. Coca-Cola.
I asked for it, I got it, Toyota.
I needed a car to get me from California to Boston where I go to school, so I had to have a car with fantastic gas mileage. Naturally, I got a Toyota Corolla two-door custom sedan, and I had to have a dependable car. Naturally, I got a Toyota. If you're going cross-country or cross-town, it's only natural to look at a Toyota.
Hey, if you can find a better-built small car than a Toyota, buy it.
You asked for it, you got it, Toyota.
Dave, you get a look at Miralem Pazlic in his own zone as Rochester will have the ball, but we've stopped time momentarily as a Rochester player, I think, Francisco Escos.
He collided with, there was a sort of heavy tackle from Nelson Moraes, who was wandering around in the background with his hands on his hips there. He really went down very heavily after that.
So the Rochester trainer out to have a look. They stop time, and there's
working on his face there. I thought he got it lower down on his body, but they seem to be looking at his mouth.
The man there with his hands on his hips is the coach of the Lancers, Dragan Popovic. Joe Sirianni is the trainer.
You see him chasing the ball, and Murray's coming in, turning his back, and he did get it in the face. You can see him clutching his face there. A very, very solid thump between those two bodies there.
So Sirianni tries to patch him up here. The paid attendance today here in Rochester is 20,005. That's an all-time record for this stadium and for soccer in Rochester. So time is stopped here, and from Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
10 years ago, no one knew me. I was part of the famous no-name defense. Then we built our reputation by being fast. Now, I don't want to lose that. I drink light beer from Miller because it doesn't fill me up, has a third less calories than a regular beer, and it tastes great. Now, everyone knows me.
Hey, I know you. You're,
Nick Bonacani.
Nope, that's not it.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
I think women are becoming a little more frightening to men these days. Maybe because we're freer to do much more. But some men aren't intimidated at all. They enjoy our freedom. Those are the men I like. And you know, those are the men who wear English leather cologne. English leather fits the way they live. It's so clean and natural, and I love it. So all my men wear English leather, or they wear nothing at all.
Look for English leather in a wide selection of gift sets.
Francisco Escos is up. He says, let's play ball. 21 minutes unofficially left in the match. Lancers down by a goal. Go to the big man, the Gunners, Stojanovic in the left wing corner. Back heels to himself. In front. Nobody there. Pedro chases it down. Beckenbauer slips. Ooh, they call a foul on Pedro.
Pedro does not like that at all. He's picked up the ball. He's running straight towards the ref. He's been restrained by Odoi. And he has to content himself by waving his arms at him. I really think Beckenbauer slipped on it. I don't see that Pedro touched him.
Looked like it to me, like Pedro is a couple of yards in front of him.
Bad pass from Stevie Hunt there. That's a dangerous thing to do.
This is Costa. Inside for Silva. Beckenbauer deflects it. Over the end line. Corner kick for the Lancers.
Well, that injury to Escos seems to have fired up the Lancers there. Stojanovic looking terribly dangerous on the left just now.
Wait a minute. They say the Lancers last touched it. Goal kick, Cosmos.
That's a little strange one. I don't quite follow that one. That certainly was a deflection from Beckenbauer.
Well, we didn't see it look like Beckenbauer hit it. It was a phantom touch there.
Beckenbauer did hit it. I certainly didn't see a Lancer player touch it after that.
So the Lancers, who feel here, perhaps with some justification, that the calls are not going quite their way as maybe they should the last minute or so.
They just got to collect
themselves and start it all over again against the Cosmos. The Cosmos have been the most awesome in the playoffs in terms of scoring goals as any team in playoff history. 14 goals in three games, including 8 against Fort Lauderdale. Take nothing away from the Strikers, though. They had a great year. Here comes Dreggie. Again, Stojanovic is camped in the penalty area. Now to Pedro, the playmaker. Goes for Stojanovic, goes behind him. Hunter with a header clear, but it comes to Pedro again. The fiery midfielder on top for Odoi. Looks for Stojanovic. Loose ball, spiked down by Messing. Cosmos again, clear it out. Racing down the field. Stevie Hunt dumps it ahead, nobody there. And Brand will pick it up in the penalty area.
They got another look at this play. Here's Odoi turning on the ball, pushing it through. Stojanovic can't quite control it. Hunter gets his ball, and there's Messing diving out full length to punch the ball away.
Pass just a bit mistimed, or they may have had that tying goal.
And Stojanovic again looking very, very dangerous.
Ballet gets a yellow card. The third yellow card of the day for the Cosmos.
Of course, that's not for rough play or dangerous play. That's simply for protesting. Pelé is now going to go up and explain exactly what it is he was doing, but it's too late. His name's already gone into Jim Hyatt's book.
Unofficially, by our clock, we have 18 minutes left in the match.
It's a big advantage to the referee to take Pelé's name rather than Dmitrievich's. It's very much easier to spell.
Odoi after the ball. Knocked away by Dmitrievich, comes to Escos. Francisco Escos ahead for Pedro. Pedro inside for Silva over his head. Cosmos clear. Hunter, Dmitrievich, but gives it right back, and the Lancers continue to push and push some more.
Well, they are moving more men up now, John. They've got far more men than nearly everybody. In fact, they've got everybody but two players over the 35-yard line.
Top of the penalty area, Don Draghi into the penalty area. Silva can't get to it. And I think they've given up a corner kick.
Roth
tried to dump it out of bounds on the sideline, but went over the end line. Inside it goes to Costa. Looks in front, deflected by Alberto. Comes way outside to Pedro. Quinalha over to contest. Now they get the ball off to Ibrahim Silva. Quick crossing pass in front. Goes all the way through, and Dmitrievich clears. Cosmos in a counterattack. Beckenbauer for Quinalha. Can't quite get it. Quinalha could have been called for a foul there, but they held the ball, so kept the advantage. Now Stojanovic, one-on-one with Roth. He's around Roth, and Roth was able to get back to push into the outside. And a weak shot saved by Messing.
Again, Stojanovic, the ball coming to him. Roth, of course, cannot push through Stojanovic. Stojanovic is like a great oak tree standing there, and he's getting the ball, he's controlling, and he's turning on Roth, and he's looking very dangerous.
Stojanovic, 31 goals in 2 years. Already, after just two seasons, Stojanovic is in 27th place in all-time history in the North American Soccer League.
Is he on the All-Star team this year, Jim?
He's not on the first
team. He's not on the first team.
Now Stevie Hunt. On the left wing, Moraes is open. Hunt runs into the middle with Dmitrievich and Pelé on the attack. Crossing pass on the weak side. It's cleared away from Tony Fee by Palahan. Now Pedro will keep it in play. Unofficially, we have about 16 minutes and 40 seconds left in the match. Still plenty of time for the Lancers, but the Cosmos with that one-goal lead. Bozlic hit him around a man, and the linesman said he lost it out of bounds.
Yeah, that was Pelé tackling him. I don't know who pushed the ball out, whether he ran it out or whether it was pushed out by Pelé. It's a Cosmos throw, and he must have run it out.
Well, you see, offensively, still a Rochester game statistically. The corner kick, 7-1, very indicative. Messing has had to make six saves in the ball game. So they scored one and put six others right onto him.
Oh, well, his Carlos Alberto doing the same thing. He ran, that was unnecessary. He ran the ball out. He's getting it right back to Rochester.
So the turnover by the Cosmos. Pedro looking for Stojanovic inside. He'll go, well, he faked with Draghi. Used him as a decoy. Now Stojanovic. The header! Great save!
Well, a lovely cross from Pedro. He really faked out the defenders, though he's going to push it out the right wing. He turned, he pushed it across the middle. Stojanovic beating Roth in the air, getting his head on the ball. Good save, low by Messing. Difficult ball to handle. Slippery and sort of low to his right.
Not a particularly easy angle for Stojanovic to get the header.
Stojanovic turned beautifully on that.
Here come the Lancers again. Pedro moving into the penalty box. dumps it for Silva, but the referee will call the foul.
Yes, I think now that's a dangerous position for a free kick. The Cosmos will probably call everybody back on this.
They will. They're all coming back. Quickly, the free kick for the Lancers after that foul.
You see Dmitrievich chasing him back, pushing his leg across, and he's clearly getting a piece of the leg before he gets the ball. The player is flattened. Free kick right on the edge of the area.
There you see the Cosmos three-man wall four, and they're not 10 yards from the ball, but they're not going to make a move. Deflected by Dmitrievich and Odoi. The Lancers just keep the ball, keep the ball. The Cosmos is trying to fend them off here. Taken away from Palais by Foslich. Ground ball ahead for Odoi. Alberto is on him. Alberto deflects it out of bounds. Throw in Rochester. Deep in the attacking zone. By our clock, we have about 13 and a half minutes left in the match. Again, our clock is very unofficial. I can't read it, for one thing.
We should say our decisions are very unofficial here, Jim.
Cosmos able to dig it out. Here comes Kinalia on the left wing for Werner Roth, moving in on the attack this time. Roth picked up by Foslich.
Oh, here's the problem.
Away.
Now, I think Rochester would need to get that ball downfield quickly. Werner Roth out of position. Stojanovic must be open.
Cosmos have it. Again, the scoreboard clock has gone out here at Hollander Stadium. Cosmos move it in. Here comes Beckenbauer. Ahead for Pelé. Can't get to it. Drenge takes it away from him. We've started a stopwatch here in the booth to keep our own unofficial time. Callahan gives the ball midfield for Pedro. Pedro, quick pass for Costa. But Alberto again saw it coming and was able to clear it away out of bounds. Throw in for Rochester. You see Alberto directing the defense there. Ball goes into Don Drenge. All-American from St. Louis University. Inside. Look out. Cleared by Beckenbauer as Callahan came rushing in from the backside. Throw in for Rochester.
They still
in the
can't get the ball away out of that inside of 30 yards zone. This is another throw in for Rochester. The pressure is still on.
Well, the Cosmos are able to withstand all this for the balance of the game. It'll be remarkable because the Lancers are putting it all up. Again, throw in. Silva to throw it in. Well, he'll hand it off to Odoi.
But again, I'm a little disappointed by the number of players that Rochester have got in the area. They've only got four players in the area. I don't think that's enough.
And here's a dangerous one, Stojanovic. He's double-teamed. They knock it loose over the end line. Give it to Rochester on a corner kick. The Cosmos argue, but they deflect it off Stojanovic.
Yeah, Palais protesting that. I don't quite see why he should. I think it was pretty clearly a Rochester corner kick.
Pedro in the left-wing corner.
This kick, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, they have six men in the area now. That's a bit more like it.
Here comes line drive coming in Mijatovic, but cleared by Beckenbauer. Hunter chases after the ball, tries to get it for the Cosmos to take some of this constant pressure off. Long pass for Tony Field. He's got Canalia ahead. They can get the ball to him. He'll go for Giorgio. He moves in, but Foslich is back to clear it. Well, Foslich may have saved a goal there off the deadly foot of Kinalia. And here come the Lancers on the counterattack. That is the voice you hear in the background of Dragan Popovich, the coach of the Lancers, shouting instructions from the sideline. Long one for Stojanovic. Can't get to it. He'll chase Roth into the corner. But Werner's going to let it go out of bounds. There you see Dragan Popovich. From Rochester, this is NASL Championship Soccer.
Shep Messing for Smokeless Tobacco.
I love soccer. And I love tobacco. But I don't light up. I get my tobacco pleasure the smokeless way. And so can you. With mild Happy Days Mint, Skoll with the fresh wintergreen flavor, and Copenhagen for straight tobacco taste. Just a little pinch between your cheek and gum is all it takes. But the best part of going smokeless? It's really relaxing. Try some.
Now, let me tell you something. I've eaten the dust of many a rodeo, and I built up some kind of a thirst. That's why I drank light beer from Miller. It has a third less calories than the regular beer, and it tastes real good. Light says giddy up to all that flavor, and woe to being filled up. And that ain't no book.
What?
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Breaking the action, and the Rochester Lancers are going to bring in Craig Reynolds, number three, who is born right here in Rochester, as you see Stevie Hunt. So Craig Reynolds comes on to replace Francisco Escos. The Cosmos have Jomo Sono loosening up on the sideline, perhaps to come in later on. So now back to action. Unofficially, we have about 9 minutes to go in the match. 1 week from today, one of these teams against either L.A. or Seattle, Soccer Bowl 77, exclusively on TVS.
Throw in Lancers.
There's Reynolds, All-American from Brockport State, is born in Rochester, has always lived in Rochester. Scored a couple of goals this year. Brought him in, I guess, perhaps hoping he'll get a little more offensive punch than Escos.
I wouldn't like to sort of guess what that's all about, unless it's that Escos is still suffering the after effects of that injury and that he had to come out. He was holding his face again as he came off.
Foul was on Moraes and a free kick. Dreggy over the ball.
I think Escos is the sort of player who wants to play every minute of every game if he can. I can't believe there wasn't some drastic physical reason why he's taken out of the game.
Dmitrievich clears it from Costa, comes to Kinalia, leads it ahead for Steve Hunt, behind him, and Pizlic hustling back. Now Odoi. Time running out of the Lancers. Again, we estimate about 8 minutes left in the match. The referee keeps the official time on the field. Here come the Lancers. Pedro Stojanovic in front. Well, he sends it outside for Reynolds. He looks for an opening. He goes around Moraes. Almost. Shot for the far side. Save Messing. Over the end line. Corner kick.
Spectacular looking save by Messing. But we're right behind that shot here. And I think the shot was going right, wide. There's the cross. Pulled down by Reynolds. Fakes his way around Moraes.
Back to live action here to the corner kick, and Messing.
There's the dive and the punch by Messing, but I think that shot was going wide anyway.
Another corner kick for the Lancers. Pedro on the left wing. Here it comes. Here goes Palahan. He can't get it. Roth was able to deflect it. Comes out of the box to Hunter. Keeps it in bounds, being marked down there by Dreggy. Beckenbauer out to Werner Roth. Ahead for Kinalia. He and Odoi after the ball. And Odoi will ride him off the play, and they're going to call a foul on Frank Odoi. Free kick for the Cosmos.
Let me just get in a word there, John, for the way that Hunter is playing at left back for somebody who's starting his first game in these conditions. He's really played a very cool and collected game. He's doing very well.
Still raining a bit here. We had a hard rain a while back, but it's just a drizzle right now. Been raining since very early in the ball game. Beckenbauer for the Cosmos. A goal here could just about lock it up with about 6.5, maybe 7 minutes left. 2-1, New York. Stojanovic scored first. Kinalia tied it up from Pelé and Field, and then Hunt gave them the lead with a pass from Pelé, but they have never given up. Lancers get the ball up right there, throw in for the Cosmos. Again tonight at Coliseum in L.A., that's the place to be out there, is Georgie Best and Charlie Cook, Bob Rigby, take on Mickey Cave, Ord, and that whole group from Seattle. Stojanovic can't get to that one, and Messing comes out to grab it. Cosmos lead it out to Tony Field. Now to Beckenbauer. MVP in the NASL this year. As voted by the players. Well, Tony Field just lifted his foot up and went right under it.
Something to do with a slippery ball. We've seen quite a lot of that in the second half. This rain on the field makes those mistakes. They look terrible mistakes, but they're excusable.
Pedro doing some dancing here in the midfield. Dreggy on the right side. Lancers have only one man back at midfield. Cosmos have everybody but Kinalia back on defense. Clear by Moraes, throw in Rochester. Quickly, Dreggy into the penalty box for the dangerous Silva, number 11, but he loses it. Well, we have just the reverse right now of what we saw when Rochester had the 1-0 lead.
Well, of course, in a game like this where the number of goals you score doesn't matter. It's either a win or a loss. If Rochester are going to lose this, they could lose it 51. It really doesn't matter.
Deflected by Beckenbauer, comes back to Odoi. Ahead for Stojanovic. Look out! Looks for the opening. Trays the goal on Roth, and he's double-teamed. And finally, Dmitrievich with the help out to knock it away.
My word, he's strong. He's sort of leaning back on Roth. There's no way Roth can get through him to get to that ball. Come on,
let's go. That dangerous 180-degree turn and a shot. And he's... Roth needed the help.
Unfortunately, he was turning the wrong way. He's a very right-footed player, Stoyanovich. He was turning onto his left foot, which meant that he had to try and pull it back. And, of course, he didn't have time to do all that.
Pelé let it go. Field couldn't get it. And Fizlich, in a sense, gives it to Pelé, to Tony Field. Back for Pelé, deflected by Mijanovic. So now the Lancers will try to get the ball out. Odoi beats to Craig Reynolds. The hometown boy against Pelé. Pelé obstructs him off the ball. Foul called, obstruction. Time, unofficially. About 4 minutes left in the match. Could be 3 minutes. Could be five, somewhere in that neighborhood.
I don't know why you're having so much trouble with the time here, Johnny.
Now the referee stops time, and the Cosmos are going to bring Jomo Sono into the ball game.
Let me see what they take out here.
Sono, number 22, for Kinalia. As you see, Miralem Fizlich from Rochester. This is NASL Championship Soccer.
When you're like John White, the sportsman and world-famous men's fashion designer, you don't just smoke a cigar, you wear it. That's why John White's designed a cigar for men like himself. Capitan. He styled the pack, bands, and four shapes to flatter your looks, while tobacco experts combined African Cameroon wrapper and mild imported filler to flatter your taste. Try Capitan by John White. See how good good looks can taste.
John Miller, Paul Gardner, the Cosmos of the ball. Time is running out. Jomo Sono, number 22, 5'8", 165. Exciting player has replaced Kinalia here in the late going.
That's unusual, John. I don't remember Kinalia being taken out of a game at all before this season.
Cosmos nursing a lead with little time remaining, somewhere about 3 minutes. The referee is supposed to make a signal at 2 minutes, and we'll try to catch it. Carlos Alberto with the ball, gives it off in the middle to Beckenbauer. 2-1, Cosmos. Goals by Kinalia and Hunt, both assisted by Pelé. Hunt inside for Jomo Sono. And they say Jomo is offside. Cosmos with tremendous depth. They actually won the game in Fort Lauderdale the other night, having taken out Tony Field, Pelé, and Beckenbauer.
A nice play by Hunt there. Very nice, very cool play. And you have to remember they played most of this game without Garbett, who's their first choice midfielder. Dmitrijevic has come on as a substitute. I think most clubs in the league would be only too glad to have Dmitrijevic as a first team starter, not mind a substitute.
Or Somo, or yes. Ramon Mifflin off the bench.
Ramon Mifflin, exactly. World Peruvian World Cup star sitting on the bench.
Playing without Bobby Smith in this ball game, their policeman in the back line. Hunter has replaced him. Hunter in his first start ever in a big game, and as Paul, as you said earlier, he's had a good one. Here come the Lancers. They need to push up. It's desperation time. They go for the money man, Stojanovic, and Alberto is there to clear it. Dregi keeps it in. Fizlich looking again for Stojanovic. Silva, Stojanovic looking for an opening, and Roth knocks it away. But again, they ask for the handball.
They want the handball. They're not going to get it.
Holohan tries to keep it in, but loses it out of bounds. Throw in for the Cosmos, and they'll take their time here. Want to thank everybody here in Rochester who has given us help and helped TBS get this telecast off in Rochester. They've been very kind and considerate, along with the City and Parks Department and people with the Lancers. Also to Jim Trecker, John O'Reilly of the Cosmos, who have helped us out with information, and Ted Howard of the league office. And we'll see you in Soccer Bowl 77, 1 week from today. Well, we have just received word from the members of the Professional Soccer Reporters. Wait a minute, the referee has called time. The ball game is over. The outstanding player of the game is Shep Messing of the Cosmos. And Shep will receive a $1,500 Copenhagen Skull Player of the Game Award. The presentation to Messing will be made by Commissioner Phil Woosdom and Bud Vanderheiden, Director of Sports for U.S. Tobacco. The game is over. The final score, New York 2, Rochester 1. We'll be back in a minute with a final wrap-up. By Turtle Wax, the world's largest selling liquid car wax. New improved hard shell formula cleans, polishes, protects in one easy operation. Turtle Wax with the hard shell finish.
is the TBS Television Network.